Good morning, everyone. It's Yvonne here from the Aussie Goddess to do you what's cracking reading for Tuesday. Thank you very much for subscribing to my channel. I wanted to just do a little bit of a shout out before I started today because I think it's really beautiful when people want to share with me what they've done. And there is this sort of sense of seeing someone start something new and wanting somehow to give them a little bit of a kickstart. So I want to show you these beautiful cards that Jane sent through to me. This is her, I love this. This is her new enterprise. Now, if you're interested in these, you can buy them on eBay. And I think she said they're available through her Facebook page. Her name's Jane Holbrook, H-O-U-L-B-R-O-O-K, I think. But if you're interested in purchasing any cards or want to know where you can buy them from, then just flick me an email and I'll put you on track to purchase these. But they're stunning cards, look. They're just beautiful. And they were taken in Amboseli in Kenya, both of them. So I'll leave you with that. And if you're interested, please, by all means, flick me an email. And good luck, Jane. What a wonderful, wonderful new start for you. Alrighty, let's get into your reading. We're going to use the Golden Tarot for your reading this morning. Quick announcements. I was supposed to go live on Instagram today. I deliberately changed it to Tuesday because I thought I would have more time on a Tuesday. But being I've been away all weekend, there's a couple of things I need to attend to, so I won't be live today. If you are interested in a personal reading with me, life coaching, or interested in joining us for groups, everything is on my Facebook page. So whip over to the Aussie Goddess and like the page and it will all be pinned to the top of the page. Also, you can follow me on TikTok now, which is proving to be very slowly, but very successful. So I'm extremely happy with that. There was one more thing. Can't remember what it was. Oh, at the moment, due to me being away for a couple of days, readings are a little bit behind. I'm still trying to get people within 1 or 2 days. But what I'm thinking of doing is putting a booking system on my web page for people now. So looking into that at the moment so you can book your own readings and then you have a good idea of when they become available. But that's it, I think. All right. Let's get into this reading. Have the deck upside down? I do. All right, so we have the Emperor coming through first. I love seeing the Emperor. For me, it doesn't mean whether this is somebody you're dealing with or whether this is actually you. There's so much power in this card. He's not so positive in the reverse, but when he's upright, he is a person who's very well educated, very knowledgeable, someone who likes to take charge, so he can be a little bit commanding. Represent somebody in your community, someone who you may look up to, you may find very, very appealing in terms of their intelligence and maybe going to them for advice. So it can be someone who holds a position of power. Could also be a teacher or somebody around you who, you know, is maybe a mentor. But whoever this person is, it's represented by the sign of Aries. So you could be dealing with an Aries. All right, we have the Judgment card. Woohoo! Somebody's getting a second go around with somebody who looks like they're coming up as the Emperor. Whoever this person is, it looks as though there is some sort of rebirth in a relationship here. The Judgment card does talk about bringing things back from the dead, the birth of the Phoenix, all of those lovely terms that we use to talk about, you know, things being given another opportunity to work, to sort of have a second bite of. So the Judgment card can mean that somehow or another you are getting a second bite of the cherry with somebody here. Now, I can look at it also that it could be some sort of reunion rather than sort of a second chance. So you could be reuniting with someone, not necessarily a love interest. This could be a family member, a teacher, a friend, but there's definitely something coming around again here. Okay, so for some of you, this is a love offer. And it does look like you're getting another opportunity for something. It looks like somebody sort of had a change of heart here. This could be an apology. The pages only represent written communication. They're not action cards, so this can sometimes be communication coming in here to perhaps resume something that you let go in the past. Again, doesn't necessarily have to be romantic. It could be somebody who's offering you a chance at something else. And it could be possibly something you've missed out on the first time around. So, for example, a job would come up this way. Somebody in a position of power giving you a second opportunity to take the cup here. But I feel like this is an apology. So I feel like somebody's apologizing. All right, we have the Devil card here. This is the card of Capricorn. Now, I feel like here this person may not... I don't feel that it's a Devil card that's showing, you know, bad energy. It doesn't feel narcissistic. What it feels like to me is that someone has not been able to let go of some sort of bond, attachment or fixation with you. But it could be that you felt the same about this person. There feels to me like a very, very strong soul tie here. And somebody here is having trouble letting go of this and they want to sort of bring it back around again. But that's what it feels like, almost like obsessive behavior here. And I know obsession sometimes can sound a little bit sort of stalkery too, but I don't feel it's that sort of obsession. What it feels like, there's a victory card here. I tell you how it feels. It feels like this person sees you as their muse, as their, they see you in really high regard. And I feel like they may be just a little bit obsessed here, but they are feeling some sort of tie or bond between you that they're not able to release. Now, this could be your energy here, but somebody is definitely coming in to apologize here and ask for another opportunity for friendship, could be for love. But I feel like with the victory card, this is either way, whether this is you or whether that is them or switched around, there is this sense of accomplishment, a sense of feeling good about what's happening here. So I don't think anything about it is negative. Now, for some of you, it could be like a family figure coming around again with an apology. But somebody here is a bit sort of determined with that Devil card to get something going again. Now I see the Knight of Wands, and I think this could have been something that's been dragging on for a very long time. So if this is you, it could be that this person has really taken their time in coming back around. So they may have had their own things to deal with. And the Devil card could represent that this person has been tied to another situation or in a very toxic situation and has been unable to sort of get away. But with that victory card, it says to me somebody's coming back towards you, possibly because they've got out of some sort of toxic situation. Whatever it is, the Knight of Wands is coming through here, not the Knight of Pentacles. So why did I see the Knight of Pentacles? All right, so it's been some time, I would say. And maybe you've given up on this person. Maybe you've given up on their energy. Maybe you've let them go. I don't feel that your person has, though. I feel like your person has a very strong desire to make things right here with that Devil card. Putting things right. The Knight of Wands is coming through here. So you could be dealing with someone who is a Leo, Sag or Aries or has those placements predominantly in their chart. But for me, the Knight of Wands can represent passion, drive, initiative. So I feel like somebody's coming forward and is very determined, especially with that Emperor energy. All right, so I have the Wheel of Fortune coming through here. So the Wheel of Fortune sort of talks about the universe turning things round now in your favor. So I would take it that something has happened with this person in the past where maybe you have been on the back foot or maybe sort of sideswiped or ghosted by this person. Because something is being put right here. Now, if this is a family member, a friend, or someone who's close to you, I feel that you didn't have the opportunity to defend yourself somehow. So you may have never had the opportunity to express yourself, to talk about what was going on. The Wheel of Fortune says you now are getting an opportunity to put things back on track. There's some sort of karma being resolved here. All right, we have the Ten of Cups coming through with the Two of Swords. Oh, you've got a decision to make here. I feel like with this Ten of Cups, there is a great deal of happiness in this situation. So there might well be, you know, a great deal of relief and excitement about seeing somebody come back in, or, you know, this circumstance change. But there's some sort of decision to be made. And the Two of Swords for me is not always the best decision. It can mean that you have to cut something out or walk away from something. Very often a heart decision. So I feel like this person's looking at their Ten of Cups. Wow, okay. So it sort of feels for me here like you're seeing this as an incredibly good opportunity. But I feel like the reason we've got the Two of Swords is because there's also this feeling that perhaps this person left you behind. Perhaps they did do the wrong thing in the past. And maybe this decision is, you know, do I trust them? Do I move forward with them? And what we see with the Two of Swords is this sort of stalemate energy, this being stuck in a decision. Because you can see here the Ten of Cups, but you can also see in the past that this has left you on the wrong side of the wheel waiting. So there's sort of this very strong energy here that you've got to make a decision on whether you take this person's apology or whether you move on here. All right, so we have the Seven of Coins coming through with the Five of Coins, wow, and the Three of Swords. I feel like here with this Two of Swords, you're worried that you may get your heart broken again. You might worry that you have great disappointment coming from this situation rather than looking at the Ten of Cups. This is the energy here. Two of Swords energy, Ten of Cups, Three of Swords. It's like, do I take this? Do I take a chance on it? Do I release it? What do I do here? Because I feel like it's almost like you all the time you were waiting, all the time you've been hanging on, all the time this energy's been around you, you felt the compulsion or the need to try and fix it or put it right. But now you've got it in front of you. It's like, do I want to take a chance on it again? And for some of you,